Hi guys, today we are going to discuss a disease of dogs, mainly canine species, that is canine distemper. So we can start. Introduction. Contagious, infectious, acute febrile viral disease of dogs characterized by biphasic fever. Biphasic fever means two phases of fever will come, and severe immune suppression, that means the immune cells will be phagocytosed by the immune cells. So decrease in the number of immune cells or leukopenia, catarrhal inflammation of mucous membrane of respiratory tract, GI tract, urogenital tract, skin lesions, and serious problem is neuronal manifestations. The synonyms of disease is carrier's disease, heart pad disease, alt dog encephalitis. Now we can move to the etiological agent or the causative agent. The agent is Paramyxoviridae, the common single-stranded RNA virus, and Morbilli virus and canine distemper virus is a species of virus. The virus is pantrophic virus. Actually, what is the meaning of pantropic? Pan means universal and tropic means to love. Pantropic means it loves entirely all systems of body and all places inside a canine body. Pantropic with peculiar affinity for lymphoid tissues and epithelial tissue and nervous tissue. It is, since it is belonging to the Paramyxoviridae and Morbilli virus genus, it will be antigenically related to PPR virus of goats, Rinderpest virus of cattle, and measles virus of humans. Now, the susceptible host, who all can get the infection? Actually, primarily affects dogs and foxes. Mainly in wildlife, it is affecting the foxes and skunks and raccoons. Out of dogs, the pups are most affected because the pups, they will be developing an immune system. So, the weak immune system is very good for the high level multiplication of canine distemper virus. Also, small pups with less developed immune system are more susceptible than adult dogs with fully developed immune system. Actually, the undeveloped immune system is the main attacking area of the virus. Incubation period is actually 3 to 7 days and usually in 5 days. But also incubation depends upon the immune system of the host, secondary infection status, the health status, the intensity of infection, the strain of virus, etc. Now the transmission. Since it is paramyxovirus, all secretions and excretions contain viral copies. Usual route of infection is aerosol infection, that is inhalation of infected droplets from an infected animal. Respiratory signs and lesions are constant. Lung is central to pathogenesis of CD due to pneumonia formation. Lung lesions varies in severity. Infection can also occur through ingestion. Chance of bordetella infection, that is kennel cough. It is a bacteria causing kennel cough. Chance of bordetella infection as a secondary bacterial infection is very high. Salmonella infection can also occur and increase the gastrointestinal problems. Now the pathogenesis. Virus gain access into the body through ingestion or inhalation. Following the entry virus, it is taken by macrophages of tonsils and bronchial and laryngeal lymph nodes. And in the lymph nodes, they multiply and produce several copies of virus. And now, through lymphatic organs and lymphatic system, they move to the systemic circulation and they introduced into the blood, which is known as hematogenous blood. And through blood, they move to the other lymphoid organs all over the body. Now, the presence of virus in blood is stage of viremia. This leads to infection and high temperature, that is fever. This will be around 4 to 5 days post days infection. That is, after 4 days of entry into the body, first fever will come. This is first phase of fever. Now, spread beyond lymphoid tissue depend upon the immune system of folds. If it is highly immune, the other immune and lymph nodes will not be affected much, right? but it is immune compromised, then the stage is very bad. Now, in immunocompromised animals, virus spread to epithelial of respiratory, GI tract, urogenital tract, ultimately reaches skin, brain, and optic nerves. Virus replication in the target tissues bring about the characteristic pathological change that they will be producing many microbiological lesions and microscopic lesions, macroscopic lesions, etc., and it will be dealt. Now, the second fever appears due to localization of virus in the different tissues and also maybe due to secondary bacterial infection. That will be around 12 days post-infection. That is, if the 0 days infection occurs, 3 to 4 days, after 3 to 4 days, the first fever will occur. And in the 11 to 12 days, second fever will occur. The second fever is actually due to what? Secondary bacterial infection and localization of virus in different tissues. Now we move to clinical signs. In young pups, the clinical signs can be seen as two phase, visceral phase and encephalitic phase. Actually, the visceral phase means the internal organs are affected, and in encephalitic phase, there is neuronal manifestations. So visceral and neuronal manifestation. So visceral phase, the diphasic and biphasic fever for 3 to 4 days, and the second fever comes at 11th or 12th day, again due to secondary bacterial infection. Conjunctivitis, nasal and occipital discharge, since the virus is multiplying in the upper respiratory tract, catarrhal to nasal discharge, and since they move to the lacrimal duct through eye, conjunctivitis occurs and they affect the ear. So after infecting the bronchial lymph node, they directly move to the lungs and produce what? Interstitial pneumonia or viral pneumonia. And diarrhea is produced because they get into the intestinal tract cells and creates electrolytic imbalances, and even they burst out the cells of the endothelium. So hemorrhage occurs. They live inside the lymphoid cells and kills the lymphoid cells. So lymphopenia. Vesicles and pustules, especially on the skin near the inguinal region and near the ventral abdomen region. In encephalitic phase, they will be showing nervous signs like blindness due to paralysis of optic nerve and forelimb paralysis due to forelimb nerves, chewing movements, excess salivation, epileptic seizures or epilepsy, temporal twitches, that is chorea, and nasodigital hyperkeratosis is a neuronal manifestation actually. Means hyperkeratosis on nasal region and digital region. It is known as heart pad disease. This is the ventral pustules in the abdominal region, and this is the heart pad syndrome. In macroscopic lesions, respiratory tract, catarrhal exudate will be there, which turns purulent in nasal and pharyngeal mucosa due to also bacterial infection. Bronchointerstitial pneumonia and viral interstitial pneumonia, actually, this is suppurative. You can see the pus coming out. Suppurative inflammation is occurring here. So it is actually due to secondary bacterial infection, Bordetella bronchiseptica. Now in GI tract, swollen mesenteric lymph nodes, catarrhal to necrotizing gastroenteritis. Actually, it is all due to the virus replicating inside the cells, and they come out by bursting the cells. So that area will be having a gap, and RBCs and others emerge through this, and this creates hemorrhage. Other lesions are thymic atrophy, hydropericardium, nutmeg liver appearance. It is a very important lesion of the liver. Catarrhal conjunctivitis due to the lacrimal duct via for the movement of virus. Corneal ulceration, panophthalmitis, meningeal condition. Microscopic lesions, it is important to check. Respiratory tract, catarrhal rhinotracheitis, bronchitis with bronchiolitis with small purulent plugs. Now, the important microscopic lesion is proliferation of type 2 pneumocytes and formation of multinucleated syncytial cells with intracytoplasmic or intranuclear inclusion bodies. Intracytoplasmic and intranuclear inclusion bodies are the feature of paramyxovirus. Sometimes epithelial cells form and the appearance of giant cell pneumonia. Epithelial cells diffuse for appearance of giant cell pneumonia. Now, in the intestine, there will be intracytoplasmic and intranuclear inclusion bodies. And also in the urinary tract, you can get formation intranuclear inclusion bodies and etc. In skin, we have intracytoplasmic and intranuclear inclusions. extensive proliferation of keratin there leads to hyperkeratosis, and this is called as hard-pad condition. Atrophy of thymus due to depletion of lymphoid cells. Nervous system, extensive demyelination, vacuolation of neurons, and spinal cord is mostly affected. In nervous system, it is non-suppurative viral encephalitis. But in lungs, it is getting suppurative pneumonia. We can get intracytoplasmic and intranuclear inclusion bodies in the astrocytes, epidermal cells, and few neurons. The option A is acute lesions. Now we have old dog encephalitis. In mature dogs that have survived the acute infection, this condition leads to old dog encephalitis. It is mainly neuronal manifestation. The demyelination is less, and it is affecting the gray matter of the cerebrum, and actually the reflex is lost for the animal. Many reflexes are lost, and it acts like an old dog. And here only intranuclear inclusion bodies will be found. Diagnosis is finding of jitter cells and gemistocytes in labs, clinical signs, postmortem lesions, demonstration of inclusion bodies, immunohistochemical staining, virus isolation and identification through virus neutralization test, ELISA, PCR, AGID, etc. And vaccination. Vaccination is controlled by RabiVac, NobiVac. These are two vaccines produced in India for the vaccination of dogs against many viral diseases, which include canine distemper, leptospirosis, infectious canine hepatitis, etc.